Navigation views are great for creating hierarchical pieces of data, where the user can drill their way through various screens into more and more details by tapping navigation links. However, they aren't so good at showing unrelated pieces of data. For that, we need a different kind of view called a tab view, which creates a bottom bar with buttons at the bottom, and tapping on each button jumps to a different view in your layout. Now, making one of these things is as simple as creating a tab view and then listing out your tabs one by one. So we'll do text, tab one, and text, tab two. However, in practice, you'll always want to customize the way these things are shown. As you can see, our tabs are there, but you can't even tell they're there. They're down here in this hidden sort of white space. If you're lucky, you can try and tap the right space to jump between them, but otherwise, it's a pretty terrible user experience. Instead, it's a better idea to attach a tab item modifier here to each tab, giving it some image and text to show inside its tab item. So we'll say in here, there's a label with the words one and system image star. And boom, it appears down there, highlighted in blue because it's selected right now by default. Then our tab two, we'll say has a tab item with label two and then system image circle. That'd be gray because it's not selected right now. Now, as well as letting the user switch views by tapping on each of these tab items here, SwiftUI also allows us to control the current view programmatically using state. Now, this takes four steps. Step one, you want to make a new state property to track the tab that's currently showing. So you might say something like at state private var selected tab is one. We'll then modify this property to a new value whenever we want to jump to a different tab. In this case, we might say that our tab one here has an on tap gesture, which is selected tab equals two. So when you press on tab one, jump to tab two. The third step is to pass this state as a binding into the tab view, so it will be tracked automatically by a tab view and remember which view it's on at any given time. So we'd say tab view selection is dollar selected tab. And the final step here is to tell SwiftUI which tab should be shown for each value of our selected tab property. So what does two actually mean? So the first three, you know, making a state here, changing it here, binding it here, they all seem simple enough. The last one's tricky. How does SwiftUI know which tab two represents? Well, because it has label two? No, it doesn't work like that. And similarly, it doesn't work like an array either. You know, it's not like we've got item zero, item one, item two, item three, because that causes problems. And what if you move your tab ordering around? All your codes will be wrong suddenly. And more similarly, if you think about it, if this thing was able to say jump to tab zero, jump to tab one, or whatever, you've got a problem where you've got an inversion of control. This child tab has information about the ordering of its parent tab view, which just is a very bad idea. And so SwiftUI gives us a better solution. We can attach unique identifiers to all our tabs and then jump around as needed. This is done using a new modifier called tag. We can say that tab two down here has the tag of two. And so now when we say selected tab equals two, it'll say, what it means is find for me whichever tab has the tag two and jump to that. That's a nice way of doing it, I think, because now we haven't got to worry about the ordering of our tabs. We can say jump to tab two and it'll do the right thing. Now, obviously, having words like one and two aren't helpful. You want to have more meaningful names like user or account or checkout or store or who knows what that are more natural. And helpfully, you can use whatever values you want here. As long as it's something that can be bound to the tab view, any kind of data. If you have a look at the tab view initializer, you'll see it wants a binding to a variety of things, right? So it's pretty flexible with what it works with. You could have integers, for example, or something else. What I would do is inside my views, I would say something like in content view, static let tag equals content view or whatever, or home view or user view. And I'd use that for my tags. So elsewhere in my code, I'd just say refer to here, content view.tag or whatever, there in one single place. And that's easier to work with than having, you know, exact strings typed in. One last thing before we're finished. It's very common to want to have tab views and navigation views inside the same application, and that's fine. What you got to remember is that most of the time, for these kinds of tabs here at the bottom across here, your tab view is the top thing. The tab view contains a navigation view, which contains a list or whatever you want to inside, as opposed to the navigation view containing a tab view. It's not always true because tab views have a range of forms, but in this default form here, that's your top level view for your application.